on my Thingiverse page, I've got the three files for you to print, a number of my mini machines, which are little replicas of consoles and old computers. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to take some of our most popular models, and once you've printed them out, how to put them together into your own mini machine. So for the purpose of demonstrations here, I've printed everything at 130% scale, just so it's easy to see. And of course, when you print your own, you can scale it up or down, whatever size you want. The only tools you're going to need is some regular super glue. I'm printing with PLA plastic. Super glue works really well on that. Some tweezers to hold things, a sharp knife for doing stickers. And then for some of the mini machines, having a clamp is useful so you can hold the pieces in place while they dry. To bring your mini machine to life, you really have to give it some color. So you've got two options when it comes to coloring your mini machines. You can either print in the color plastic that you want to finish with, or you can paint. Some of the colors of these old machines, like the old Mac and NES, which have that kind of putty color, you can't find plastic to print with in that color. So then I just print in white and use a regular spray paint. This is Rust-Oleum. There's nothing special about it. It's just regular spray paint that I can get hold of easily. I use two colors a lot. This is Satin Fossil, which is that kind of putty color, which is good for kind of, you know, if you take old electronics and let them sit around for a long time, that's the color they take. And then if I want to show something that looks kind of newer, I've got the Satin Stone Gray. One coat spray on, and it doesn't affect the stickers, and everything looks really nice when you're finished. I typically will paint everything before I do gluing, just to make my life easier. Okay, this is the Xbox One. Typically I would print this in black, of course, because it's just a big black block. I printed out four controllers. They're all the same, of course. This is just simple, one piece, you put a sticker on that. The Xbox itself only has two parts. It's got the kind of main body, and then this is, which is supposed to be the DVD drive. So this you could have in silver. Super simple build. You just add a little bit of just regular super glue into the channel, just a tiny bit. Then you can slot the DVD drive in there and just hold it in place for a minute or two until the glue sets. And at that point, that's it. Your Xbox One is done. Okay, this is the Sony PS4. So I printed it at 130% scale, so you can see things a little bit more clearly. I printed four controllers. The controllers themselves are very simple, just a single piece, and we'll apply a sticker over there. For the body, you've got these kind of five parts. So the way this works is you take some just regular super glue. You take the center body, which I typically print in black because it's kind of shadows in the center of the machine. You're going to apply a little bit of super glue to the ridge and to each side. And then we're going to set it in that center channel. Then we'll apply a little bit more super glue to the top. And we will put the top part in. Now, things to look out for here is you want to make sure that these two lines are aligned correctly together. And then we're going to set it on a flat surface like this. And then we're going to add our clamps and let it set. And the reason we do this on a flat surface is if you want to display your PS4 standing up, just make sure that it'll be balanced. So then the only thing that's left to do is these two fins, which are actually the kind of lights. You can print these out in silver or blue. It looks nice either way. The way I like to do this is, once the glue on that center has set, I'm going to grab a fin in a pair of tweezers like this. I'm going to add a little bit of glue to the bottom here, and then just the dot over there and over there. And then I'll take the body of the machine and I'll kind of slide it into place. And because of when the glue is there, it tends to stick to the center. And then you can use the tweezers to kind of position it exactly as you want, and then wait a minute or so until that's set, and then do the second one. And so that's the PS4. Okay, this is a Nintendo Switch. It looks way more complex than it actually is. We're gonna put most of these pieces aside for now. We're gonna focus on these two. This is the actual console, and then this is the frame that goes on top. All you need to do here is take some regular super glue and apply it to these kind of raised pieces here on the frame. And then once you got that in place, you just put the frame in a hole. Now, it's very important that you use just the smallest amount of glue. And the reason for that is, once you put the frame in place, it's formed a kind of channel here where we can put our screenshots to switch in and out, so we can display the machine running different games. If you put a lot of glue, then what will happen is the glue will sit there, and when you stick a piece of paper in, it'll set into place, and that's no good. The rest of these pieces are the interchangeable parts. So this is the dock where you can put the machine in and out. And then you've got the Joy-Cons, which have got these kind of hooks, which you can slide in and out. And of course, you don't glue these in place, right? Because you want to be able to show the machine in its various configurations. So you can put this away there, and you can slide this into the controller. And that then is the Nintendo Switch. Okay, this is the Wii U. It comes in quite a few pieces. This part is just the remote. We're just going to add a sticker over there, so that's pretty simple. Then we are going to look at the main controller. This consists of three parts. We've got this main part and these kind of little mushroom-shaped pieces. This is pretty simple to build. We're going to take some regular super glue, just apply a tiny dot inside that circle. Then we're going to put our mushroom piece in there and then just kind of hold it in place for a minute or two until the glue sets. And then we'll do the same for the second one. I typically print this in black and then the mushroom piece is in gray. And then once that's all set, we'll apply a sticker for the screen. Now the actual Wii machine itself comes in three pieces. We've got this kind of main piece. This is a plug which fits in the back. And then this is the interior of the machine. I typically print this in blue because if you look inside a Wii U, it's got that kind of blue glowing part. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this piece with no glue and we're just gonna pop it in the bottom and make sure it lies flat. Like that. Once that's flat, we are gonna add some glue to the sides of each of the inside over there. Then we're gonna slot this plug into place, which then presses against the blue part we just stuck in, and then I'm just gonna hold that in place until it sets. And then when that's done, that's the Wii U complete. The last part of building any mini machine is to apply the stickers to them. So you can get the stickers at Thingiverse. I give them together with each machine as a PDF. And I just use this Avery label sticker paper. You buy these for putting labels on envelopes and so on. And you can print on here with your regular printer, inkjet or laser, it works just fine. So once you've printed, you want to use a knife and a ruler, and we're going to cut as close as we can to the machine, sticker itself. And then we will kind of lift it out. And then just apply it to the right place on the mini machine. Just as simple as that. And once you've got all stickers in place, then your machine is done.